something that's very important.
Nettoyage spirituel.
The title is spiritual cleansing.
Amen.
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 So many people in their lives. They have difficulties in advancing the things of God. They're living through so many blockages. There's no breakthrough in the things of God. There's no breakthrough in their daily lives. They've got so many difficulties. They don't know how they'll move forwards. And they don't know what they will do. Now the danger of all of this is when they all come into the church. Now, each and every single person on the spiritual plan, they have not had a spiritual cleansing. So now we've all come into the church. We're going to live in something impossible. So now we will all experience the same problems in our lives.
Amen.
Amen. Because spiritual cleansing. It can stop you from moving forwards in your spiritual life.
Alleluia.
Amen. You will feel your physical life is blocked. Your spiritual life is blocked. You'll be in the church as if you're not even in here.
Amen.
Amen. People are praying and it's like you're not even here. So you are unconscious with the things that you were doing. Everything is blocked in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
That's
why it's very important. You see, when people begin to talk, why have I got so much struggles? And then they start condemning God. But we don't know where these difficulties come from. And that's why I want you to pay attention to me. The road is a way to find out how we should have spiritual cleansing. There is a way where children of God are being attacked by Satan. There is a certain road. There are certain roads that children of God go through spiritual attacks.
Amen.
Amen.
Why?
Because foundation of so many people
is contaminated by the devil.
Is contaminated by the enemy.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Fondement ya vie na bango, fondation ya vie na bango.
The foundation of their lives
is contaminated.
Is contaminated
par le diable.
By the enemy.
Sans qu'il y ait pas.
Without them realizing.
Sans qu'il comprenne rien.
Without them understanding it.
Mais là ils viennent à l'église.
And now they come to church.
Ce temps toi dans l'église tu penses que tout est bon.
So now when we come to church, we believe that everything is fine. No. There are certain things that need to be followed on. The good thing about this, what is the good thing about this? You must understand. For you and I, if these things come into our lives, you need to have a total deliverance. The book of Psalm
11, verset 3,
11, 3
dit ceci.
Says this.
Psalm 11, verset 3.
When the foundations are being destroyed, what can the righteous do?
Psalms 11, verset 3 et lobby.
Psalms 11, 3 says,
quand les fondements sont renversés,
when the foundations are being destroyed,
que peut faire le juste?
What can the righteous do?
Amen.
Amen.
To find it. Leur fondement,
when the foundation
is renversé,
is being destroyed,
que peut faire le juste?
What can the righteous do?
Ce qui fondement est mutu est renversé.
If someone's foundation is being destroyed,
or fondement est mutu est où t'en as combattu ma mutu,
or someone's foundation comes from someone else, is birthed from someone else.
N'angola n'anga bien.
I need you to listen.
Leur fondement est boucani.
When your foundation is broken,
le juste,
the righteous,
va courir à Jésus.
Will run to Jesus.
Faut qu'il me prenne à Jésus Messie.
He must run to Jesus.
Parce qu'il prenne à Jésus Messie.
Because with Jesus, that's when we'll get the understanding.
Justice solo,
righteous, true righteousness.
Sanctification.
Sanctification. That's where we'll get. We'll get it from Jesus. I repeat it.
Quand les fondements sont renversés,
when the foundation is being destroyed,
le juste va courir.
The righteous shall run.
Comprends pourquoi?
Now you need to understand why. Why is my foundation of my life destroyed?
Je ne suis pas comme les autres.
I'm not like the others.
Pourquoi je ne fais pas ce que les autres font?
Why do I not do what others do?
Quand je veux faire cela, ça n'arrive pas.
When I want to do it, it never happens.
Même dans les choses de Dieu,
even with the things of God,
j'ai des difficultés.
I have difficulties.
Dans les choses du monde,
in the things of the world,
j'ai des difficultés.
I have difficulties.
Qu'est-ce qui ne va pas?
What is happening?
Faut se poser beaucoup de questions.
You need to ask questions.
Fondation à Bissau,
our foundation,
se réfère à notre famille. Et donc, Ezali, Kolansana famille na yo place au bimel.
Is a part of our family.
Amen.
Amen.
Experience.
Life.
Position na yo spirituelle vis-à-vis ya bomo na yo liboso ya Nzambe.
Your spiritual position before God. All of these, you need to understand your foundation of life easily.
L'expérience subie dans votre vie,
your experiences in your life, what can it be?
Tu as rencontré des difficultés,
you've come against a lot of difficulties, and now you don't know how to receive answers. And sometimes you sit there and you cry. You want to advance, but you can't. But then you see people next to you advancing. Now all these things, when you see it, you see that as we are born, especially us who are born in Africa, we are bound by so many satanic things.
Alleluia.
Amen.
So,
if the word of God did not come, then we wouldn't have been. A lot of grandparents, they consecrated a lot of their children.
Alleluia.
In witchcraft. That means child is born, and then the grandparents, please look after them. And the grandparents just throw a bit of powder. And our grandparents have given children weird names. Once upon on the first day, I was telling you a story. Some people got the name Take Misery. I studied with a guy called Have Misery. So he was someone that I grew up with. And the name they gave him was Receive Misery. All his life,
misère na misère.
Misery upon misery.
Amen.
Amen. And that's why it's very important to understand what I'm saying here. While being born, there's a thing that a child is born in the placenta. In our countries, they've manipulated a lot of placentas.
Amen.
So as the person grows up, they don't understand that all these things will follow them. Others, they're controlled by the alliances that their grandparents signed. A child, when they're born and grows up, he doesn't know the alliances that their parents have signed. Their parents, when the child is born, they sign the alliances with God. They give their child to God. And others, their child is born and they give it to Satan. So all of this will bring bad luck. Now these bad lucks are gonna happen in your life. You'll see that up to today, so many people in the church, even when they pray, you see their life isn't stable. You need to understand yourself. You see there's no change on the spiritual plan. Now if someone comes to God, a seed should show. There shall be a change in you. You can never stay the same person. What was the work that God did on the cross?
Amen.
And that's why it's very important to understand these things. And that's why I said there are ways that we are coming before problems. We're going through problems in our lives. The first way, it can be through the enemy, Satan himself in person. Who's
12?
Okay, so that means you can understand the word.
Les chemins par lesquels nous affrontons les difficultés, nous allons au lieu de affronter ma difficulté.
The ways that we may come before difficulties.
Y a l'iboso.
The first.
Et cause de la activité satanique.
It can be satanic activities.
Quand vous m'avez raisonné bien.
Now think about it.
Depuis que vous êtes en avant.
Since you've been coming to the house of the Lord.
Depuis que vous êtes en avant.
Since you've been listening to the word of the Lord.
Et loco nini.
What is happening in your life?
Job 2, verset 7.
Job 2, 7.
Hello, baby. Just take the verse and study out him. And Satan said to
him, just take the verse and study out him.
And Satan se retira devant la face de Satan a se retiré du bosso ya Nzambe.
And Satan came before God.
Oui, il frappa Job. À qui commettait Job?
And went to hit Job.
Job a bandi kobele.
And Job became ill.
Bandana makolo tina somme ya mutu. Job a bandi kobele.
From the feet all the way to the top of the head.
Mukare na nzambe bike.
The word says.
Satan a longwe di boso ya nzambe.
Satan came away from God.
Aye pa Job.
He went to Job.
Aye kobete Job.
He went to hit Job. And Job began to get a lot of boils. He got a lot of all the way to the feet. To the top of the head. So we must understand this. Job's problem was satanic activities.
Amen.
Amen.
Donc, ma difficulté nous saute aux os dans la carte de vie.
So some difficulties that we might experience in our lives
is about activité moro satanique.
Is satanic activities.
Tout mon exemple est moi sur une Luc 13.
We've seen an example of a woman in Luke 13.
Mukanya na zambe lobi.
The word of God says.
Moi si en gros, azali ki babenga ki e fille d'Abraham, moi na Abraham.
The woman they called him a child of Abraham. daughter of Abraham.
Mais Azaki tenu courbé depuis 18 ans. Hein? Satan a gumba qui a fait courbé.
And she was folded, Satan folded her from the age of 12.
18 ans.
18. But the Bible says, calls her the child of Abraham. How is she the child of Abraham? But she's been in alliance with the devil at 18. So she was a child of Abraham. But she was held by the enemy. Satan is not scared because you come to church. He doesn't care because you touch the Bible.
Amen.
But Satan, if you give him the way, he'll take his place and he'll enter with ease.
Donc, another
way of difficulty that you might be experiencing isn't God, but came from the enemy. The things that came to Job is what came to this woman as well.
Job,
the person who beat him, was the enemy.
Alleluia.
Amen.
The
word says,
Satan se retira devant la face de Dieu.
Satan took himself away from God.
He
came and went to hit Job. So the demon came from speaking to God. He said to God, Lord, God, Job is good because he's working for you. But if you'd give me a way, I'll touch Job, you'll see how he's going to deny you. So Job's suffering, the enemy that brought it. He said, God, so you know that Job works for you. Give me a way to touch him. A lot of people are suffering because, like Job, without them realizing. It's not God. Your blockages, your difficulties, your problems. Here is Satan himself. Second, another way that we can come through difficulties.
2 Timothy 4:14.
Are we reading the name of Jesus? Alexander the metal worker did me a great deal of harm. The Lord will repay him for what he has done.
Alexandre Forgeron.
Alexandre the metal worker
m'a fait beaucoup de mal.
Did me a great deal of harm.
Le Seigneur le traitera conformément à ses actes.
The Lord will
Amen.
Amen.
Tomonia, okay.
We see here that
souffrance oyo, Paul has all about.
This suffering that Paul is talking about,
Oyazwaki,
that he came upon.
Alobi, Alexandre le forgeron.
He said, Alexandre the metal worker
m'a fait beaucoup de mal.
Did me a great deal of harm. But the Lord will repay him for what he has done.
Donc, il est donc certain que la souffrance d'un croyant.
So sometimes the sufferings of a believer. Can come from people who are evil. The same with Alexander the metal worker. Let's not follow the fact that we come to church in our suits. Other people come who are really evil wearing the clothing of a Christ-like child. Here Paul's talking.
Alexander Forgeron,
he says, Alexander the metal worker has done me a great deal of harm. Some things that you're suffering, that you're coming against, can come from your friends.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Nicole.
In school,
la université,
at uni,
na musala,
at work,
partout,
everywhere you walk.
Qui te dit que ma camarade nous va bien?
Who told you that all your friends are good?
Amen.
Amen.
Non, ne, que ma camarade nous va bien.
Who told you that all your friends are good?
Bah, tous les camarades.
All your friends.
T'as bien.
Look properly.
Vire, maman,
what are their lives like? The word says, Alexander the metalworker did me a great deal of harm. He did me a great deal of harm. And you're crying to yourself. So sometimes when you don't have a prayer life, if you don't want to give yourself to God, you will get some attacks from your enemy, from your friends. You think your friends are laughing with you, but their hearts you do not know. Oh, I like the way you are. Do you know in their hearts what there is? And because you're a weak person, you don't pray, you just go home and go straight to sleep. Have you not had dreams where your friends are following you and stabbing you in your dreams? How many times have you dreamt that? God opens eyes for people to see. How many times have you seen a certain person and chasing after you to do you wrong? Alexander the metal worker did me a great deal of harm. All the sufferings that we may come against. Because you're condemning God. Oh God, why am I not advancing in my life? Why am I not getting married? Oh, why am I not moving forward? Why am I not receiving? It can come from someone. Amen. It can come from someone. From someone that you know properly. That he can do you wrong.
Alleluia.
Amen.
The
Bible says,
Paul
is telling Timothy.
Timothy
was his child, who he loved dearly. He told him, oh, my child, my suffering has come from nowhere else. He knew him very well, Alexander the metalworker. But it was Alexander the metalworker that was very dangerous.
Amen.
Amen.
Donc, Baninga,
so, beloved,
Alexandre,
there's so many Alexanders. There are so many Alexanders in our lives. Don't follow the fact that someone is praising you and says you are so extraordinary. You are such a good brother. You are such a good friend. I'm so happy with you.
You
could be Alexander the metalworker.
Amen.
Amen. The person who wrote this was Paul. But Paul is a great servant of God. So how is he now crying to Timothy saying these things? He said, this man, the metalworker, he has done me a great deal of harm. God will repay him. So I was saying, so there are some sufferings that children of God go through that come from evil people. evenness of people, those who do people wrong, outside some people may not see it, but it's hidden inside. So if someone wants to kill someone, they'll kill him from inside their heart. And outside they're fine, they're saying hello properly.
Amen.
Amen. So you must be careful. With everyone that you walk with, know their lives. We've got, why do we have the Holy Spirit? So that he may show us who we are living with, who we're being around, who we're walking with, who we're sharing the same environment with. Alexander and Paul were together. But Paul wrote that he did him a great deal of harm. There's some other things in our lives. If God says he'll open our eyes, I reckon you'll die straight away. You'll see how people are plotting against you. God will open your eyes so you can see this. You will cry and you'll say, God, I'm dead. I don't want to see this. But God protects us so we do not see. Let's believe that the work of the enemy is there. Today, so many people are acting as if the enemy does not exist. They don't even want to say the name of the enemy. They don't even want to name the satanic activities. But Satan isn't your friend.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He, even if he tells you, I love you, till he kills you. For those who go into the world of occult to do magic, if you hear the good things that the enemy says to them, I've done so many deliverances in Congo and here. If you must listen to what the enemy says to them. But in the end he says, you, I'll kill you. But he already told them that he loved him. So if someone lives with the spirit of evilness inside of them, he'll throw you bad luck without you realizing.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Sometimes you may be praying, and he's praying satanic prayers against you. Other ways of suffering. We read it here.
2 Peter 2:8.
2 Peter 2:8.
Source musus. Ya souffrance ya batu. Deux Pierre 2:8.
Chapitre 2, verse 8. For that righteous man living among them day after day was tormented in his righteous soul by the lawless deeds he saw and heard.
Amen.
Amen.
C'est juste. Moto oyo azaki juste.
For that righteous man
qui habitait au milieu d'eux, azaki na kat na bango,
living among them,
tourmenté en effet,
was tormented
jour après jour son âme,
in his righteous soul day after day,
à cause de ce qu'il voyait.
Because of what he saw.
Et attendait de leur agissement criminel.
And heard.
Moto yo juste.
This righteous man.
Bisika sa ikovan.
Where he was living.
Ibe bika sa ki juste.
To say he was righteous.
Amen.
Amen. But where he was staying, he was tormented by the things he was hearing and seeing. Criminality was, there was too much criminality. Too much bad news was happening. So everything that he was living through in his environment, he was going through these sufferings. Even though so you can be righteous, but you need to check check where you are, your family, where you come from, and things that you see that you're living through. It can destroy your life.
Amen.
Amen. So for those who just come,
chemin.
The title was spiritual cleansing. So if there's no spiritual cleansing in your life, you won't advance. You will advance and go and keep going backwards. Some good things that you're meant to live through, you're not living through. You're only living through difficulties. Because you haven't gone through a spiritual cleansing. Spiritual cleansing is very important for a child of God.
Psalm 11, verse 3. Amen.
Amen. What did it say?
Psalm 11, verse 3. Quand les fondements sont renversés, que font les justes?
When the foundations are being destroyed, what can the righteous do?
Our foundation is the way we are born,
our foundation is the way we are born, our lives. So if they haven't placed a house, the foundation of a house properly, it will fall.
Alleluia.
Amen. Every house before it stands, it must stand on top of a good foundation. So your life must depend on the foundation of being of when you were born.
Alleluia.
Amen. So if your foundation is good, you see that the house will stand up beautifully. If the foundation is
bad,
what shall you do? You should run to God. So that's when I was showing. So many people's foundation is falling because of these ways that I'm talking about. First word. Suffering and difficulties that you may be going through can be through satanic activities.
Job 7:2.
There they said, Job came from God. Satan came from God and came to hit Job from the head to toe. He suffered severely. Which means
the
source of your suffering can come from the enemy. And now you're just looking at God and condemning
him.
Where did your source of your problems come from?
Satan,
God, where did it come from?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are
you listening?
Jusqu'au plant du pied, quelle souffrance je m'en ai dit.
What kind of suffering did Job go through?
Amen.
Amen.
Discern souffrance où vous vendez pour regretter chaque jour.
Your sufferings that you go through every day.
Chaque minute, chaque jour.
Every minute, every day. You're regretting for over your life.
Et où tu es?
Where does it come from? We've seen where Job's one came from. The enemy bought it. The second, as you walked in,
was
Paul was telling Timothy, his child. He said, Alexander the metal worker has done me so much wrong. God will repay him. So that's what I was saying. The source of difficulties, the source of blockages and illness can come from those evil people. Paul says, Alexander the metalworker is an evil person. So that's why I'm saying that other people, you look at them, you see them and they're good. Do you know their hearts? When did you become God? Yeah, you're my friend, I love you. So did the Holy Spirit open your eyes to tell you that he was good?
Alleluia.
Amen.
He said,
this horrible man has done me so wrong. I didn't say go and tell your friends. But just discern who you stay with, who you eat with, in school, at uni, at work, everywhere you go, who are you with?
Amen.
Amen.
Alexandre le forgeron m'a fait beaucoup de mal. Ça, c'est Paul qui dit.
Alexandre the metalworker has done me so much wrong. That's what Paul said, and he is a man of God.
Alleluia.
Amen. A servant of God who actually saw God.
Jesus.
Crying. So you're not even on his level. So should the enemy scare you or your friends who are evil?
Amen.
And that's why we see the suffering of children of God has so many origins. Here we see that it comes from evil people. So now we're at the third point, source of suffering of children of God. It says the righteous who are living, were tormented every day. The righteous,
à cause de ce qu'il voyait,
just because of what he saw,
à cause de ce qu'il entendait,
just because of what he heard.
Donc juste wana,
so that righteous, like someone righteous coming to just live in this estate.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Juste wana King's Cross,
that righteous person comes to live in the house in King's Cross. Now where he's come to live, he's heard so many things. He's seen so many things. He's seen so many criminalities. And now it's made him ill. There are things in the spiritual plan. You've now heard so many things. You've seen so many things. You've heard so many things. And now your soul hurts inside. You know, sometimes inside you say, oh, my chest. And sometimes it's from what they've heard. No one's hit him. It's not Satan. It's the shock of what he's heard.
Amen.
Amen. Have you not seen when someone's told bad news, they get shocked and then they go to the hospital and die? So
sorts
of difficulties inside of you does not come from God, from Satan. What is chasing after you every day has grown so much illness inside of you. Has birthed so much difficulties in your spiritual
condition.
The cause?
L'entourage.
Your entourage.
Juste habiter au milieu de ces gens ici. De cet homme juste.
This righteous man lived in the middle of it. The Bible says he was righteous. He was good. But his entourage. The French say, a man is born good, but society corrupts him. This person, people are usually good, but maybe, and even your foundation of being born was good. But as soon as you left your house, things that you heard has traumatized you. Has ruined your life. Don't you see people that play PlayStations and game consoles. If you turn the Nintendo around, you'll see it says that it gives epilepsy. But you see fathers and sons sitting there playing it. And they sit there and play it in the sitting room.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And when they sleep at night, the guns that they were playing will now come in your dreams. So you must be careful with the things that you see.
La télévision.
On telly. You stay awake until 4 or 5. And you watch things that are not. You watch things like vampires. In your subconscious, it's marking something. You know, some people, that's what they dream of, vampires. When people like watching the things, people dying, horror films. So, source of suffering can come from a system of the world.
Crise économique.
Economic crisis.
Alléluia.
Economic crisis. Be a source of difficulties for children of God. Someone wakes up in the morning, they go to work, and they're hoping they get paid, and then they get taxed. And because they don't have a prayer life,
shock.
And they get a shock when they look in their bank account and see no money. So many people are ill because of this.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Source
of suffering, especially in these days, economic of the world. You hear the conversations on the bus. Right now, we've got to go. On the telly, they're showing. They're talking about Cameroon and they're not happy with things. And if you see their faces, they're traumatized. They're
Amen.
So you see so many homeless people, the things that they heard, the things that they saw, and because they have no God in them, the source of their suffering comes from them. Have some self-control.
Amen.
Amen.
Car c'est juste qui habitait au milieu, avec qui tourmenté.
Because this righteous man that was who lived in this place was tormented because of what he saw and what he heard.
Et là on a eu un mot.
What have you heard? And what have you listened to? And what have you seen?
Milieu de sous-zonyata.
Every circle that you enter, control the things that you hear and see. Otherwise, the source of your difficulties will come from what you've heard and seen.
Amen.
Amen.
System ya mukili.
Worldly systems can cause problems for a man's integrity. They'll be tormented in their spirit, in their soul, and in their things, systems created by the world.
Hallelujah.
Amen. For you to succeed and become this title, you must do this. Do not do it. Leave work. Sign this so you can be the manager of the society. Peabody will give it to you, Chico. You'll be the boss man of this place. Just put your hands here, say yes. And if you put your hands there, it's finished, you've taken the title. Listen, agree to be poor and go to heaven and put your hands in this place. They're showing how the Illuminati started in America. They started in Germany.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The Illuminati started there and got involved in politics of the world, economics of the world, is what involved in everything. All the way to the Statue of Liberty. They're saying that the people, who built it were Illuminatis. And now the Eiffel Tower and all the other things, they're the one who built it. And now these people are powerful, they've entered everywhere. Now they're showing one who built, I can't remember his name. He built this huge building and they've put his statue in front of it. And now they're showing how he does great things in the world. Do not follow the big things that people do. Some people do great work, but you don't know how they did that.
Amen.
They were mystical people. And now the world is celebrating them.
Amen.
Amen.
Donc, souffrance,
so other suffering can come from
vie charnelle d'un chrétien,
a fleshly life.
Amen.
Of a Christian.
Vie chrétienne charnelle.
A carnal life of a Christian. A carnal Christian. Their suffering can come from the fact that they're carnal but still at church. The word says, others, it's true they're doing the work of God. And it's true that they're preaching the word of God. In the way of disputes.
So we tell you now, 2 Timothy 4:10.
In 2 Timothy 4:10.
We tell you now, in Philippians 1:15-17. Comment ça? Na 2 Timothy 4:10 balobi.
In 2 Timothy 4:10.
Car demain m'a abandonné. Demain abandonné ngai.
For Damas, because this world had deserted me. For Damas, because he loved this world, has deserted me and has gone to Thessalonica. Crescens has gone to Galatia and Titus has.
Car demain m'a abandonné pour l'amour de ce siècle.
For Damas has deserted me and has gone to Thessalonica. It's very difficult to pinpoint the source of our problems. Don't blame it on anyone. So many children of God are on people.
Transfer of difficulties. So
they're blaming their difficulties on someone else. Don't blame no one. Look at the source of your problems.
The
Demas has abandoned me for the love of this world.
Demas
was carnal.
Hallelujah. Paul said he
abandoned me for the love of this world.
Our sort abandoned.
Here we see the sorts of. There were some believers who are spiritual.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's
not the fact that you come to church. You look at the seed that comes out of someone's mouth. The word that comes out of someone's mouth. Their conduct. And you'll judge them straight away.
Demas.
He traveled in the work of God because of his fleshly desires. So now they class him as a Christian.
Source of our problems.
Source of our problems.
It comes from the fact that you're still from your
flesh.
Il y a des difficultés vraiment.
There are some difficulties.
Pour la belle à part.
For a lot of people.
Pour la connu ma kenoba problème où ils vont vivre.
To believe that the problems that I'm living comes from myself.
Et belle va se spécialiser ma koloba boye.
So many people are saying this.
À transférer ma problème pas na mutu songolo.
They're transferring their problems onto someone else.
Ndima reproche. Na kati aloba nzambe. Ndima baye bisa yu vérité
na. Except that they tell you the truth, to be told the truth.
Peut-être pas na mauvaise vie na yo.
Sometimes because of because of your bad life and the actions that you might stop blaming your suffering on someone else, it's yourself. A lot of problems that we may face is the result of our actions.
Galates 6, 7. Elobi, c'est qu'un homme aura semé, il y en a pour récolter.
What a man reaps, he shall sow. So he shall reap.
Alleluia.
So the things that we may hide, whether physical, whether visible or not, we think that God won't see, but he does. The Bible says there's nothing hidden before God. Everything is open and is being seen. He's seen it open. So everything someone may, if you're sowing something good in your life, if you're sowing something good in your life, you shall reap it. That's what will come back to you. But if you're sowing something bad, you shall reap that. But the advice I'll give you, sow good things so that good things shall come back to you. Speak good things and good should come back to you. The source of your suffering, bad things that come out your mouth,
amen.
And that will come back to you.
David a semé qui semence à destruction.
David sowed the seed of destruction.
David has a basi na ye.
David had his wives.
Mais amori moi si monsieur général monsieur capitaine monsieur basoda.
But he saw another person's wife.
A tiki basi na ye.
He left his wives.
A kuzo monsieur abat.
He went to get another man's wife.
A sumo bal latin ye na guerre.
And sent the husband to war.
Bal akira guerre. Bache na rey
monsieur. The husband went to war and they put him first and killed him.
Alleluia.
Amen. And people cried. And David knew what he'd done.
Alleluia.
Amen.
The
people outside were crying. Why did this man die? But it was David who told the general to take this man and put him at the front of the line so he could be killed. The blood of an innocent. But in return, it came back to David. His children became husband and wife. What a man shall sow, sow badness in your life if you're a child of God. Have a mouth of goodness in your mouth.
Alleluia.
Amen. Be happy for everyone. Speak goodness for everyone. It shall return. If you speak bad, they shall speak bad for you.
Amen.
Amen.
David
sowed what he reaped what he sowed. What happened to David destroyed his family. His children, he saw his child being raped until they killed each other. One thing brought so many things. What things do you sow? What things do you sow in your mouth? In your heart, what do you have?
Negative.
Negativity.
Alleluia.
Amen. What do you sow? And what do you reap? If you lift someone up, they will lift you up.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Lobaka,
so you should say, you're
yo
good.
Bien.
You're great.
Yo
you're good. That's what you should say. If you don't do that, what you do is what will return to you. The last. God can be a source of our problems. God can create problems, and He allows Satan to come in your way. He allows the problems to come to you so that you may come close to Him. God will see that you've weakened, you become weak. Weak to serve and weak to pray. To giving yourself to Him is there's no giving yourself to Him. So now God will create problems so that you may run back to Him.
Amen.
Amen. He can cause problems for you so that you may go back into your life of prayer that you began with.
Moni Naman, na katia Bible, mokonzi basoda, deuxième roi chapitre 20.
2 Kings chapter 20.
Na hotel histoire ya Jonas.
Read the story of Jonas.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Jonas a qui un jeune homme très orgueilleux.
Jonas was arrogant.
Ya kusanganate. Prenayende mutusaike. Aba oh nzamba Israel azali.
It was because of his illness that made him believe. Do not be arrogant.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Do not be arrogant and say, the things of God I'll leave. What will that do to God? Oh, I'm not going to pray. What will it cost God?
Hallelujah.
Amen. What will it cost God? Nothing. God killed Sodom and Gomorrah.
Sodom and Gomorrah. Abomi bangwa detruit bangwa.
He destroyed them. He killed them.
Sodom. Gomor.
I don't know if
it's in the same thing.
Sodom and Gomorrah. Gomorrah.
Hallelujah. Zamba detruit people wana nyoso sinsi bangwa.
God destroyed all those people and finished them.
Donc bat bakomi mabanga poussière.
People became turned into powder.
Sotam bisusaka orgueil bangwa.
So when you become arrogant, what do you think? So sometimes your problems come, and sources, one, you abandon God. To abandon God doesn't mean you leave church. It means that you may be in church, but you have abandoned. Your spirit, your soul does not participate in the things of God. Now you are searching for problems with God. Everyone, as we sit here, has a mission in this church. If you do not accomplish a mission, they will not be filled by someone else. God does not create photocopies, just original. You are your own original. So now, when God has placed you in the ministry,
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you have
said no. Whether they put someone else there, the person will not be like you. You are unique, and God has made you unique.
Faites attention.
Be careful.
Jonas. Jonas.
Yeah. Man of God.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Jonas, serviteur de Dieu.
Jonas, the servant of God.
Amen. Hein? Mais Jonas, Zamba ebisebo.
But God told him.
Go to
this place where they called
Nineveh. Alleluia.
Amen. Go to this place. And preach to these people so that they may get their life back. Because there is so much badness in there. And Jonah said, I've heard that there's so much danger. God, I'm sorry.
Jonas kende.
God came back and said, Jonah, go.
Jonas came to the beach.
Jonah went to the beach and found a boat. First boat.
Tars.
Going to Tars. Second, going to
Nineveh.
And he said, I'm not going to Nineveh. I've changed. I'm going to Mars.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And in the boat of Tars, there was goodness. So now I'm analyzing it like this. Not the Bible, but myself. So there was great music, great things that made me happy. And he looked at the boat of Nineveh and said, nah, I'm not going in there. The second, that boat will take us to Nineveh, they kill people. So he went to the boat of Tars. And he sat, and the journey went.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I need to concentrate. Amen. Amen. Fortuna. Les doyens du bureau politique des interprètes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tout le monde est conseillé, parce qu'on a concentré. Amen.
Amen.
Jonas a continué à battre, nous avons battu qui est.
Jonah went into the boat. God left him. You see, sometimes when people do things, when people revolt, God allows them to just go. And you see, you'll see things and you think that they're actually goodness from God, and you think that it's following you. And people say to you, you're great. You are so sick. And you come and you say, oh, ever since I've revolted, good things have happened. These people in the church are playing with me. They won't see me again. God is allowing the boat to go. And he says, if I tuck Jonah, because the boat is so close to the shore, Jonah will just swim back onto the shore. You see, you understand how God thinks. So he said, let me just leave Jonah. So the boat continued. It got to a place where Jonah could not jump in and go back. He got to a place where there was so much water, he couldn't swim. Amen. See the water here, what do you call it? The Thames. There's a place that's huge, and there's a place where I could swim. Next to Waterloo, I could swim there. Now, if you go to Dagenham, you'll see that it's bigger. You can't swim there. They let Jonah go all the way there, and on the boat there was fun stuff going on, and God let him stay there. And God said, voila, little person, I will touch you good.
Hallelujah.
And he got to a deep part of the water, and God blew. Jonah, in his subconscious, knew that when the wind came, the second wind came, and he thought, yep, I was told to go to Nineveh. I didn't go. And that wind, there was more wind. And
God's wind
just him himself and stop him. I'm the one who did this.
Capitaine,
because the captain, they traveled with their family. So he would die with him, his children, and the other passengers. The boat would have stopped. But God refused for it to stay. He just wanted it to move so that he could trouble them. See, some things that come, God don't want you to die, but he wants you to go through suffering so that you may not die to him. You're the naughty person.
Amen. You're the naughty person.
Well done, Glory, well done.
Amen.
Amen.
He
wasn't listening. The wind became worse. And once it went up a notch, he said no. This is what I must do. He went underneath the boat. And he went to hide there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The captain of the boat. And said, when the man is here, they let everyone else on the boat. You know, if God wants to shake your things, amen, if you're a hypocrite, God wants to shake you in your house. You do things and you're all holy, and they, God will make sure that they'll catch you, that you are actually the horrible one. So now all the things will come at once. They're looking for him over here. Jonah came and hid underneath the boat. He said, no, we must look for him. Let's look for him. So now they unlocked the boat. They found the servant of God. He was hiding underneath this. Don't hide.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If I was you,
amen.
After this preaching, I'll lay on the floor and say, God, it's over. I'm coming to the end. We entered the things of God for the first time. Father God, if you say E, I will know. If you say H, we were young people then. Stop chasing after women. Are you listening? And we decided in the choir, yeah, we walked outside. And me being a naughty person, I said, it didn't even enter me. So there were these three girls. My uncle had houses and one of them was free. And the girls came to see us. Two left and one stayed. I heard outside that our uncle, his uncle saying, oh, they came and left a girl at my house. Uncle came. My auntie, my grandmother, and they came with this young woman in the car. When I looked, it was a woman that I used to be with. And I looked and I saw her. Her name was Anne Marie. The car stopped. Her dad, they lived next to the American embassy. Her father came out. He said, my son. And I said, hello, father. And I looked in the car, saw Anne-Marie. He said, is your father there? I said, yes. I went and got my uncle. I thought they came to see each other as old friends. They put to, and then I heard Miss Cole and Marie come. I started swearing from head to toe. Anne Marie stood there, sat there. He said, I've come, my beloved friend, because of your friend, because of your child. This girl came from Switzerland. She was a good girl. But when she met Player, so the dad was explaining. So I stood behind. So Benjamin said, I see, my brother, you don't listen, you see?
In brief, they stopped each other from seeing each other. So the girl cut herself. Did I marry her in the end? So my uncle said this. The day I hear about this, I'll go in prison. So now we're going back to the story of the choir. So Father Gala gave us this advice. So we got to the house where the girls had come to see us. So the one girl stayed and her two friends went. I heard outside a car. Uncle came. And I said, yep, it's over. I told her, go into the bathroom. She went in the bathroom and I locked it. So me and Albert stayed. Ask him about it, he'll tell you. I put the key in my pocket. My uncle came and said, well, no, I'm just looking for the key that I've just hidden. I said, oh Lord, I'm dead today. We looked at each other. He said, where's the key to the corridor? I have to look for the painting in the bathroom. Now, if I give the key, this girl's in the bathroom, so now I'm dead. So I thought about the advice that I was given. We were told, do not make trouble. My uncle stood and said, I want the key. And I said, oh, I left it at Albert's house. And he said, go and get me the key. And I said, okay. Straight away, my uncle stayed, locked the door and went. And we weren't supposed to get a key, but the key was in my pocket. Now, when we were to get the key, to come back, the front door was being locked. Now, the key was in the bathroom. And my uncle was only going to come back on a Wednesday. I said, oh Lord, I'm dead. So we knelt down and we started praying. Lord, I will never do this again. If you help me. I said, Lord, if you help me with this one thing, everything that Father Gala says, I will obey. Oh, Mother Mary, help me. And Albert just stood there and watched. And God listens to pagans as well. I heard in my spirit. Put your hands where the flowers are. I put my hands there and found this old rusty key. And I told Albert, look at these keys. I went to the door that the uncle had locked and gone. I turned it, the door opened. I said, I said, thank you, Lord. Since that day, I stopped this life of women. Because it was getting to the time where God was calling us. Amen. So that's why I'm giving this example of the things like as Jonah. When Jonah went underneath the boat, he saw him. He said, don't throw me. I know why this wind is like this. I know where this came from. If you throw me in the water, the wind will calm down. So let's go back into the preaching. Now you understand the source of bad luck. Who caused it? Who provoked it? The captain was innocent. Some sufferings that we endure, as a father, it might be one of your children. Sometimes it's not children, it's the father. Someone in the family is the doors to suffering. So the boat is signifying family. It's signifying the church. The suffering of the boat came from Jonah. Because he refused to obey. So God said,
hallelujah.
He judged himself. He said, take me and throw me in the water. So don't be stubborn. If God calls you, amen. You see me? I come from far. There's so many stories I could tell you. So sometimes just give yourself. They freed Jonah and the wind was calm. The captain began to drive the car. See, the church can be calm. But because someone here is Jonah, suffering will come. People don't want to listen. People want to be rebels, don't want to change. So there shall be the source of suffering in the church. Are you hearing me? They threw him in the water. Luckily.
Hallelujah. Erezma, to suki wana Simba.
We'll stay there.
I Erezma. To continue on go. Jeudi.
We'll finish on Thursday.
Erezma. To continue on go. Jeudi.